Are you guys ready? Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, live from Fairfield, Connecticut, the story of Monkey and Leopard. Leopard did not sneak up on cute little fuzzy animals and grab them and eat them for lunch. No! Leopard primarily used his claws for slicing and dicing vegetables. Right? Let's say you were going to have a big stew, a big soup. He'd go up to Leopard and he'd say, "Hey, Leopard, I got some carrots. Could you slice and dice for me, buddy?" And Leopard would be like, "Oh, king, oh." And there, the carrot peel sliced neatly, and so off they hit the stew. The leopard would be like, "You can pay me by just giving me some stew." It was good, life was good, but it was a little bit boring. And y'all said, "Boring!" And one day, Elephant had an idea. She was like, "Oh, you know, I had an idea. If we took a little bit of our skin and stretched it over a log of wood or a frame, we could make something I'm going to call a gazebo." And Zebra was like, "Gazebo? Don't be calling it a gazebo." And everybody's going to go, "Zebra, gazebo, gazebo." I get enough flack as it is for all these stripes. "Okay, let's call it a guacamole. Let's call it a bologna sandwich. Let's call it..." They did not know what to call it. Finally, I think someone said, "Let's call it a drum." Yeah. "A drum." Because it says drum. Or maybe a drum drum. Wait, trumpet, trumpet. Or a shaker thing. So all the animals said, "Hey, what a great idea, everybody." Monkey stood up in the council of animals and he was, "I think it's a bad idea. If I took enough skin from my skinny little body to make a drum, I would be cold, even though I live in equatorial Africa where it's always hot. A boy needs his skin, you know what I mean?" Well, all the other animals said, "Fine, suit yourself, everybody." And so they all went on to make drums. Elephant made a huge joom joom, boom, boom, boom. Zebra made a cool djembe, kabop, jubadah, kaboo. Rhinoceros made a cool standing drum. By the way, you never mess with a rhinoceros, just in case you happen to meet one. They're not friendly, okay? Squirrel made like a cool shaker thing. Yeah, yeah. And then they all, Leopard made this cool and groovy rain drum. And he learned how to make this cool woo-woo sound on it. Which I forgot to explain it earlier. It's the same effect of around the rim of a wine glass. You ever made a wine glass kind of ring? Growl. Leopard was very pleased with his drum. And they all got together and they decided to have a big party. Can y'all say party?
Party!
And they started to jam. They took the cute little pink paws and they started playing. Now, you're gonna go boom, boom, boom. You guys are gonna go shave your hair, cut, two, cut, shave your hair, cut. Thank you.
don't know if you've ever seen your cat or your dog, and they start out these little kittens with cute little pink paws, and they're not pink anymore. You know why? Because at night, while you're asleep, they sneak out and play the drum. No, I'm just kidding. Sometimes I gotta tell those little kids, I've been up there and back, I'm just kidding. Some of those older guys thought that was true. I can see, I'm like, oh, my cat! I didn't know he was a drummer. Anyway, so they played, until finally it was time to go to sleep, and they all stretch, everybody stretch. And they fell sound asleep. Now when you get on the sound, soft on the sound. Who should come sneaking around late at night? But monkey. Now monkey had not made his own drum, but he still wanted one. So he comes up to elephant's drum, just be playing. You're not elephant. Not really, you're too inflated drum, but you gotta use our imaginations over here. And he was like, oh, this drum, it looks too big. Sorry. He comes over to Zebra's drum, he's like, too many stripes. I'm more into the spots. I want the stripes. He comes over to Rhinoceros' drum, and even Monkey knows you never mess with a rhinoceros. That's right. And Squirrel, wasn't a dog, it was a shaker. And he sees Leopard's drum, and he just takes it. It goes back to his little place back in the forest and the jungle. And the thing is, he was a really good drum. He starts playing with his hands, and his feet, and his tail, and he's jamming out going crazy with his belt. And then even Monkey fell sound asleep. And the moon began to set. This is the moon right now. And then the sun began to rise. It's now the sun. I could be using my imagination. Then who should wake up first? An elephant. An elephant decided to invent the alarm clock. Very primitive form, true. But yeah, three times big. Boom, 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 go. Rise and shine! And the animal was like, can y'all do that? I have a feeling you know how to make that sound every morning. Boom. And she did it again. Boom, boom, boom. And the other animal was like, okay, fine. I can play the drum at 6 in the morning too. And then I'll grab the drums and they started to play a different rhythm we're going to play. Whatever you play. Samba. This is easy. Spots, like, chill, okay? Hey, but
Even Leopard knows you never mess with A. Hey, Squirrel, have you seen? And right about then, Leopard just, I don't know, something just kind of flipped in the switch in his head. And he didn't feel so mellow and peaceful all of a sudden. And he was like, oh, someone took my drum, I feel violated. Hey! Who took my drum? And all the other animals started singing, Leopard, Leopard, who took drum?
Leopard,
Leopard,
who took drum?
Leopard, Leopard, who took drum? Leopard, Leopard, what you gonna do?
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 He did that all of a sudden. Right there. Leopard made history. What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? What am I gonna do? I'll grind his bones to make my stew. And just then, all the animals remembered stuff they had to do back in the jungle, and the clearing was empty. Now, if animals had those drawers in the kitchen that just everybody dumps stuff in, that day, those drawers would have gotten organized, because they were like, oh, I gotta look busy, gotta look busy, gotta get away from Leopard, gotta look busy. Leopard was left alone in the clearing of the jungle. And he invented a couple of things. He invented camouflage. Everybody put your hands up in the air. Now I'm gonna hunker down in the tall, you're the tall grass. Now in the back row, you can't see me, right? Because I'm camouflaged, right?
No.
Yeah, right. Okay, put your hands up. Leopard spots make him look so cool and groovy, and yet when he's in the tall grass, those spots somehow make him just disappear.
Camouflage, a great invention.
Then he also invented patience. And he waited, and he waited, and he waited, and he
waited,
and he
waited,
until the sun was hot and high overhead, and who should come walking down the trail?
You guessed it.
Monkey cat. Now, monkey, you'd think you'd be carrying Leopard's drum carefully, don't you? You're dragging it down the trail by his tail. He was rolling it. He was messing it up. It was getting dirty and nicked and holes in it and cracked. And it was just, that bird was getting angrier. And angry, but he waited, and he
waited,
and he
waited,
until the monkey was right in front of him.
I need that ominous sound. Just keep going with the ominous sound.
Right in front of him, and he jumped up and grabbed him and started shaking. Monkey's like, what? If you eat me right now, I'm so skinny, you'll be hungry in 15 minutes. But if you do what I tell you to do, I'll get bigger every time, and you'll be able to feed your whole family. I don't believe you. But I feel that perhaps pulling you up in the air might tenderize you. Well, if you throw me up in the air every time I come down, I get bigger. The higher you throw me, the bigger I'll get. Okay. It took a
move. I thought we were going to do a drum roll on the way up and then a on the way down, okay? When he hits the ground, okay? So it's a good idea.
Whoa! Yeah, get back down!
He popped himself up. Everybody popped himself up. Huh, said Leopard. I think it's
kind of
working. He picked him up again.
Ooh, ooh, ooh. Whoa! Okay, he comes back down. Pops himself up. Leopard, I don't want to hurt your feelings, but I was playing this game the other day with an ant. Not your Aunt Esmeralda. Ant, the little thing that walks on the ground. He threw me all the way up to the tree.
No.
I can throw higher than that. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Whoa!
Even bigger, huh?
Leopard, I don't want to hurt your feelings or anything, but I was playing this game the other day with Mouse. And Mouse threw me past the tree.
guy. And as I passed the tree, I approached the moon. There's the theme that I've had for the program. The moon. Ah. And as I approached the moon, I noticed it was made of green cheese. That's not traditional African, I put that in. And tell you what, Leopard, if you throw me to the moon, I will bring you back some cheese. And you can invent something called horse dupers. Some people call them hors d'oeuvres. But horse dupers, that's a great idea, because you give it to the people that come visit your house, and they get full on the horse dupers, and then you have leftovers from dinner. It's a great idea.
I don't know, Leopard.
But I feel like throwing you even higher, and you took them there, ooga, ooga. Keep ominousing, ooga. Whoa! Through the leaves of the tree, out the other side, and all we move. And Leopard was just sitting there waiting for Monkey to come back with the cheese, and the other animal began to slip back into the clearing to see what was going on. Hey, squirrel, how you doing today? Don't worry, I won't slice and dice it, man. Monkey's gonna bring the cheese, man. We're gonna have these horse dupers things. It's gonna be good. We're gonna have a party. It's gonna be really cool, man. And then I'm gonna eat Monkey. Good barbecue, man. What? What? Monkey's in the tree? No, no, he's in the moon, man. In the tree? I should look up at the tree. I should. And there was Monkey making all manner of rude faces. Now, you're not allowed to make rude faces in school. However, you can play the part of Monkey for the next 3 seconds. Rude face at me. Okay, now stop. Okay. You got so much self-control. It's awesome. Well, hey, Monkey, come down here so I can eat you. And what do you think Monkey said?
No.
He said, no way, Jose. Can y'all say that?
No way, Jose.
And to this day, where do monkeys live? To this day, what do leopards eat, like vegetables and stuff? They love monkey. Monkeys are their favorite thing, if they can catch them, right? Well, and to this day, drum roll please. To this day, you never mess with a drummer's drum without first asking permission. 1, 2, 3, 4, shake, haircut, together.
Thank you.